Because judging from where I come from one of the very, very remote village in Ogara. I have a primary school there. After my primary school, I attended my secondary school with a wife's pub bicycle. So small that they had to tie, who know Ugbomo? These people here, all of them are young people. There used to be that apple shade that they use in carrying children. Then if your leg is not tall enough, just like what they did to me here, next time when you invite me, please get a chair for my size. So I'll put that on and I'll ride to Ogarife about an hour ride every day. Then after that, after my secondary school, I made only 4 credits. And the 4 credits, no English, no maths. And then once you leave secondary school, it's like the world is in your pocket. I went to Lagos, met my uncle, who then was a very big man in Hebrew Seafoods. I needed a job. And the man looked at me one day and said, you say you want to work? I said, yes. What kind of work? The only work you are good for is security. You have only 4 credits. What are you doing in Lagos? And it became a national anthem. Each time he has visitors, he will tell them, this is my uncle's son. He had only 4 credits and he needed a job. And I can't employ my uncle's son as a security guard. So, and he was not doing anything for me. His wife left him and I became the cook of the house. 5 o'clock, I wake up every day to wash his 504 saloon car. And we're just like that. Until one day I decided to say, let me go out. I went to another uncle in Ikorodu. And I spent some days there. When I came back, he told me, well, Ben, that man you went to visit, your father is next to his father. Me, your father is my grandfather's son. So that is closer to you. You have to go back there to stay now. I tried to explain to him, no, I was just trying to find a way around. I said, no, you have to go back. Well, as luck would have it, I went back to my cousin, no phone, nothing. So well, they said I should come and stay with you because I was away for 3 days. And he said, okay. He got me a job as a factory worker in Cameron, a pharmaceutical company in Lagos. I was in charge with other young men, bottle washing. That's what we do. We wash the bottle, those drugs you see. There's a machine that spins them around. So we wash the bottle. When there's no bottle to wash, we went and we fixed the cartons, we pack. And our salary there was 5 naira a day. At the end of the month, you are supposed to get 150 naira. But that 150 naira, because of my youthful exuberance, I will sit and say, people are not going to work on Saturday and Sunday. Why should I be going? I don't go. So I get about 120 every month. From there, I was able to get a house. I now had to go back, got the 2 English and maths. I did a diploma in computer science, and I got some elevation. Then in 1992, I came back to Delta State when I lost my job because I couldn't get another job with a diploma. People have started coming out from university then, HND, BSc, computer. But who are be to be a graduate? Who won't sponsor me? I came back to Delta State, got a job with an oil prospecting company, CGG. Worked with them for some time, and a friend challenged me that you are too smart. You are just too smart to be parading this certificate. Go back to school. That is how I got to Delta State University, and I studied business administration. Guess what? 20 years after my secondary school in 1984, I got a bachelor's degree in business administration in 2004. That's exactly 20 years, 1984 and 2004. So it's never too late. That's one. And in life, people, everybody will never love you. Don't expect, don't give up to people that people, because people does not love you, think you have lost it all. Forget about their love. Love yourself and believe in that self that you are the best. I'm a very private person in the public world today. I love my life as a private man, but posterity, faith, has thrown me to the world to be a public person. If I have my way, I love that my small room, sit down there from morning till night, play with myself and play with the people that can come into my inner room. but that I no longer have. That's how Rona and Co was able to track me on Twitter. I sit there. When I sit in my private time, I just do things. I just talk what I think is right, because I'm in government, but I'm not in government to speak for government at all time, because my life is to speak for people. And when the government is doing what is right, I praise them. When they are not doing what is right, I will still tell them that this is not good, especially when we have a political system where everybody seems to be loyal and they are more to their party instead of the people. For me, I believe that my allegiance is to the people, not to any political party. You can't aspire. When you aspire, you must be ambitious. The only man that is not ambitious is the dead man. The only man, they say every man is a political animal. You must be ambitious at all times, because if you are not ambitious, you sit in one place and you remain there. But when you are ambitious and you are able to articulate your issues, you move forward and the world will move along with you. There's nothing wrong in being ambitious, because it's like climbing. You can see the picture there. The man has said he's climbing up and he will definitely get there. For me, I have decided I'll get to the top of my choosing career. I've chosen politics and governance. I am going up and I will go. And I'm sure everybody wants to go up here. Then you are not too old. There's no time. It can never be too late. Whenever you choose to do it, you do it. Many more people have figured out who they want to become. Yes, because many people, they don't look at it. They don't even check themselves. They don't know where they have that comparative advantage that they should use. Some persons just believe because Ben Igbakpa is a politician, he has made it as a politician, I want to be a politician. You might be an investor like Francis here. You might be somebody, our economy now is very open. China, if you go to China, their landscape is rocky. But today they are able to feed themselves and they are pushing food to us in Nigeria. Our agricultural sector is very open. I tell you, if there is any business I want to do today, it's production. We need people that will come and produce, be it pharmaceutical, be it health issues, be it food. Some persons here want to be governors. Some persons here want to be legislators. Some persons here want to be industrialists. But first, have you built the foundation? The foundation is education. You must have that foundation. If the foundation is there, then you are good to go. You must build that foundation so that aspiration, that dream you have, you can get to that dream. So let us know, it's not just enough to say, I want to own a very big company. What have you done? You know what is called smart person. The smart person is that person who succeeds among equals. So many persons will go to university. So many persons we call with good degrees. But how many persons use that degree? I told you that I left secondary school with 4 credits. I know of my colleagues that came out with 9 credits. I was able to meet up their 9 credits later. And today I am far ahead. But some of them who got the 9 credits then went to sleep. They are not the smart one, because they didn't move up to get to where they want to be. So you must have that aspiration and be the smart one. That is it. Because if you don't have a plan, you must define the plan. You must follow it. Master the practice of what you want to do. Today, I have mastered what I want to do. If I become the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, right now as we are sitting here, I have my blueprint that I will interpret that will make the difference in Nigeria, because I've chosen a path that I'll follow. So you can be whatever you want to be. All you need to do is to believe in yourself. And I tell you, let us look at the cycle of ambition. One, you dare to dream. After dreaming, you have to dream smart. Dream smart is to doing extra. Not just to say we all belong to the same flock. Be the one that is outstanding. Just stand out. Get something better. Then you start to learn. Because nobody knows it all. For anybody who says, I have been this and I can no longer learn, then you are started the plan to failure. Then when you start learning, you learn to walk by putting that learning to action. After that, you work to become. Like I said, I wanted to go to the House of Rep. I didn't just sit down after meeting with my people. I started meeting people. I started consulting, like doctor said. You started consulting, you started meeting kings, you started meeting the ordinary man on the street. You started meeting young people that would think alike like you. You don't need, it's not just about the money. Yes, we spend money, but money cannot do it for you. You must try as much as possible to put up that thing, that nomenclature you want to be called with. Is he a trustworthy person? Is he coming with something that really will benefit all of us? The people are not fools anymore. Nigerians are getting better inclined to politics. And if you think you can just come and lie, then in 4 years they will wait for you. Whether you like it or not, our electoral system is getting better. Now, after that, you become again. Because the cycle does not end. I just told you that I want to get to the peak of my choosing career. That I am in the House of Reps does not mean I'm going to sit here. I must move someday. So you become again. And you go back to that dare to dream. So it's a cycle that will go on and on. So for me, the take home here is for all of us to believe that we are what we want to be. You are automatically what you want. For anybody that wants to be a governor here, you are a governor already. It's left for you now to start planning how to get to that point. Am I going to wait till when I'm ready and I'll just contest for the governorship? Am I going to start as a counselor? Am I going to move to be a member of the State House of Assembly to get some experience? Am I going to work as a civil servant so that I know the working of government? So you do that. I have this quote here. If you have a great ambition, take as big as a step as possible in the direction of fulfilling it. The step may only be a tiny one, but trust that it may be the largest one possible for now. Because that is what you know for that moment. You must start it that very moment, do it that moment, and after achieving that, you cannot think of going higher. Thank you.